544, we are tracking the tropics. In fact, Jason's just putting the finishing touches on your forecast.
Yeah, looking at some of the new information here with the 5 o'clock advisory on Tropical Storm Fiona. The hurricane hunters were actually in the storm overnight, so just combing through some of the data. And what did they find? They found that the storm is struggling, and that's pretty evident too, looking on the satellite imagery out there this morning. As we take a look at that 5 o'clock update, winds at 60 miles per hour, and actually down to 50 miles per hour, excuse me, and the gusts up to 65, movement to the west right now at 15. So we have seen a little bit of weakening here overnight. And as we take a closer inspection of the storm, one thing that's really evident is where the center is right there. You can see that swirling icon as it approaches the Lesser Antilles and where all those thunderstorms are. And it's, you know, honestly, a bit of a surprise. It's been able to maintain strength like it has because it is getting sheared apart and dealing with some of that dry air. So we'll have to watch it closely as it continues to move on that westward track. And even if it doesn't strengthen a whole lot, it's still going to bring a lot of rain here to some of the Caribbean islands, the northern Leeward Islands, where tropical storm warnings are in place. Puerto Rico now is under a tropical storm watch, and they're going to have to deal with several inches of rain as we get into the weekend. The forecast now for Fiona is to gradually take a turn here to the north, and we'll want to watch it closely. This is kind of the area that I'm most interested in as a forecaster, what's going to happen as it interacts with some of the high mountains potentially of Hispaniola, because sometimes that could be a wild card. And if it's lower in intensity and strength, that can actually end up changing the track. And maybe it goes a little bit farther west. If it's more organized, I think it's going to stay on the right side of that forecast cone and more quickly take a turn here to the north. And just looking at the GFS, the American forecast model, as we look through time here into the weekend, there's that circulation with Tropical Storm Fiona as it continues that westward motion. And there's Puerto Rico. So you can see some of that heavy rain around Puerto Rico as we get into Saturday night and Sunday. And this is kind of the critical point where we're going to be seeing how close it's going to move over toward Hispaniola. The GFS actually takes it just north of the island, and you can see that faster turn here to the north, well, east of Florida. Some forecast models actually bring it a little bit farther west here, closer to the Bahamas. So we're not completely out of the woods yet. I think most likely we're going to see that turn to the north, but I just want to watch it and see how it's going to interact with some of the islands. And the reason why we expect it to take that turn to the north is because this ridge of high pressure, which is currently kind of sprawling from the U.S., the center of the U.S., out into Bermuda. This is the Bermuda High. It's expected to weaken and break down a little bit as a trough dips in from the north, and this should provide it with an escape route if it's organized enough to kind of take advantage of that. And that's what the forecast models are seeing and why it's bringing it to the north. But if that ridge is a little bit stronger, it could go a little bit farther west. So that's why we want to just watch it closely in monitor mode. Nothing to lose any sleep over. Right now, we still have plenty of time to track the progress of Tropical Storm Fiona.